Hey characters, welcome to Crank It Up. I'm Jim Price, and today, I want to talk about the Spider-Verse. The Spider-Verse faction relies heavily on specials, and cards that can take an alternate form when played in Phase 2 versus Phase 3. The Spider-Verse consists of a collection of spider-themed heroes from different realities that come together, much like Into the Spider-Verse, the relatively recent animated film. I must admit, with many of the Marvel factions, it's hard not to want to dive into the source material and reflect that in your design wish list. For Spider-Verse, I really wanted the threes to be three different characters to reflect the wide array of the Spider-Verse, but those factions are harder to balance, and it's no surprise that simplicity remained. The Spider-Verse can be played in two different methods, the normal way and the specials way. The specials way involves them not even trying to win bases normally, instead using their specials to steal bases as they are scoring, letting someone else do all the work. Spider-Verse can be really strong in this regard, but not necessarily for the reason you think. It actually starts with Spider-Man 2099, which is very strong too in the context of Marvel. When it comes to removing characters from play, destruction is by far the most prevalent, even though it is seldomly used in Marvel. And since Spider-Man 2099 is immune to destruction, this makes it very likely that he can guarantee presence for at least second place. In Marvel, there is only one card I can recall that can deal with him, and that's Lift and Carry, the only antagonistic movement card. There is no antagonistic shuffling, no returns, no placing from the top of my head. From a Marvel perspective, Spider-Man 2099 is basically immune to everything. The floor is second place, but the ceiling is so much higher because of Miles Morales. Miles Morales can be played regularly as a 3, but that is unlikely. The ability to steal a base is much stronger, and you should not be character starved because of the efficient second places you can get. Miles is different from Shinobi in that he gets less power, but requires a character there, but can cap at 6 between the three of them. Miles is great on Simkaria because each one can be a VP, while the lower power may actually be benefiting you if it nets you more than 4 VP. Of course, if you can steal that base away from a singularly powerful character strategy, then stealing the base is even more impactful, as it is for most bases. Spider-Man can recover the power from Miles Morales. Spider-Man is often misread. Spider-Man should read as, after you play a card that contains the word special followed by a colon, you do not need to actually use this special ability. It just needs to contain one. And including the word special is not sufficient. It must actually have a special ability, which should be read like an ability label. Spider-Man is at the heart of the steal because Spider-Verse can play more cards in Phase 3 than Phase 2 and will act in accordance with many Black Trooper strategies. While Spider-Man's presence telegraphs a ton of information, the ability to steal something significantly makes up for the predictability. That leaves Ghost Spider as someone you might lead with in Phase 2, who gives you a bit of card draw and deck manipulation at the same time. But Ghost Spider also has her uses in Phase 3. In some respects, your partner faction is your Phase 2 faction, while Spider-Verse is your Phase 3, and you need to split their cards accordingly based on what you can do on your turn and what you should do on someone else's. Many cards can be played in Phase 2 or 3, but really should be predominantly played in Phase 3 only. It helps to start with the cards that are Phase 2 only. Without these cards, you may be passing on 50% of your turn, or possibly more, because they may not always be automatic plays. Spider-Verse Bond is an easy play, especially for Spider-Man 29 because it's a giant trap. As I've mentioned before, there is no character modifier destruction in Marvel, making this a fairly safe play since neither character nor modifier can be destroyed. With Miles Morales, this also normalizes his power, allowing Spider-Man to combine for extra power per Miles. With Spider Reflexes, this is a bit of an odd fit because of the extra action, as this faction doesn't really play in Phase 2, and lacks the ability to play it in Phase 3. Its ceiling is best when combined with terminal plays where you are hunting for more specials, but that doesn't really manifest in the way I played this faction or others have played it. It does make sense if you are using Ghost Spider as part of a burst, because you should have more knowledge of what is coming and can combine the knowledge for more certainty. Webbed Up, ironically the only other card that can deal with Spider-Man 2099, can be used as a slowdown, where the ability cancel is far stronger than the negative power. Spider-Verse don't really care about power in Phase 2, because they are going for the steal anyway, but the ability cancel makes this a strong counter card. And then there's View from Above, one of their double features. I've discussed this card internally at length, and this card certainly has its fans, but not me. I'll try my best to keep this portion short. Yes, it can guarantee you access to a character or an action. But to me, this is action draw card, with several downsides. As a double feature, you would hesitate to say action because you might draw the other copy. Character is the more likely card, but given even splits, it's hard to justify that ability over drawing two cards. It draws its strength from a character imbalance like Kaiju, but that also exacerbates my other problem with respect to Spider-Verse. For this card to be valuable, it needs to be able to overcome the chosen card type being buried down far below, but it reveals a ton of information that is particularly damaging to Spider-Verse, because every special card shuffled back in communicates a card that you are not likely to have in your hand, which offers a player more certainty when it comes time for them to prevent the steal. The floor of this card is that you draw one card and it is revealed. There are easy ways to make this card more interesting, but in my opinion, it's unfortunate that it exists as a double feature in its current form. Regarding the remaining cards, they really should be used for the steal. With great power can bring an average amount of power in Phase 3, basically another Miles Morales. Comes great responsibility can bring an extra character in, and with the right character, the ability could far outweigh the loss of one power. Unfortunately, Comes Great Responsibility does not combo with Spider-Man, because Spider-Man was not in play at the time it was played. If only there was a rule that allowed that, that'd be pretty cool. But if you do swing in with Spider-Man and play a bunch of specials after, Spider-Man can lead the charge for stealing the base. As far as synergies go, it's a lot harder to synergize with Spider-Verse in Phase 2 than in Phase 3. And like the Ultimates before then, copycats are naturally going to be strong, with ninjas and mega troopers standing out. But there are other partners that can do some more interesting things that tend to fly under the radar. The clerics can be deceptively powerful with Spider-Verse. You now have two cards that can cancel abilities, and two cards that can sap power, one of which is extremely potent. For a faction trying to steal bases anyway, really forcing someone to overcommit can drive someone insane. Deepfire makes for a great Comes Great Responsibility play with Spider-Man. Deepfire has a special ability, so it will trigger Spider-Man, but it will also save Spider-Man. An unexpected Deepfire can send Spider-Man flying into another base. Been and Gone can also save Spider-Man. With all the specials that you have, recurring them with Cardinal and Collection Plate makes it very hard for someone to overcome you. Since Spider-Verse are usually punting their Phase 2 action anyway, using it to reload and get more cards can be incredibly impactful. The game plan here is pretty clear. Use Spider-Man 29 for easy VP while building up a Spider-Man who can fly from base to base and wreck everything. Sticking with Munchkin, the Halflings are another great Spider-Verse partner. The Halflings play from behind in Phase 2 anyway, so giving them a partner who plays from behind in Phase 3 actually allows you to break bases on your turn, knowing you can edge them out in overtime. What's particularly brutal is that the Halflings can start a Spider-Verse chain from nothing with Last Call. Last Call cancels the ability, but gives you the character you need for everything else. If you have a double lunch run base, then each Miles Morales can be insane card draw as you are stealing the base, drawing many of the next specials you will be playing. And ironically, Miles Morales is a good target for Last Call because you won't lose the power. Spoiled brats to recur Miles Morales means that they have to beat you once again by at least 6. With a card like Out of Nowhere, the view from above actually gets stronger because it gives you the lopsided ratio you need for the card to provide value. I suppose I can't talk about Munchkin entirely. Continuing with the non-traditional partners, the fairies are a very good partner for Spider-Verse because their cards are surprisingly aligned with the Spider-Verse strategy. Because Spider-Verse isn't really trying to win in Phase 2, skipping a turn for Spirit of the Forest makes a lot of sense for a first turn play, and even a mid-game play. Titania with Spirit of the Forest is a great candidate for Comes Great Responsibility. If you play her on someone else's turn, you have a fresh ore statement to double, returning a minion and playing a minion which can be incredibly impactful, especially if the other minion is on another base. This can give you Spider-Man on another base for a double score. Puck's Extra Action is another great candidate because you can create a Lightning Rescue and use any number of cards. Enchantment can normalize the power from Miles Morales even more. Glimmer Stall plays perfectly into the overpayment strategy, forcing people to commit more on a base you are going to steal. Daisy Chains offer further slowdown. Ladybug can turn a Tinx into a Spider-Man 29 for the same type of leadoff play, while also providing destruction immunity for Spider-Man because there are cards that can target this powerful character who is key to their strategy. One thing you'll notice about the Spider-Verse is that they have a great threat to steal, but that it takes up space in their hand, limiting them from doing much else. In many ways, this is the same problem that the Orcs can have, but the Spider-Verse are actually less equipped to play in Phase 2. For a pairing that can compete in both phases, this is actually a robot pairing I can endorse. Because you are stealing on someone else's turn, a Fixer can be a great pivot minion, especially if the chain ends with an Alpha on another base. This not only normalizes the Miles Morales power, but gives you a great head start in a way that ninjas never could. Robots give you the benefit of being able to play in Phase 2 and 3, loading up on power, and allowing you to overtake someone if they even try to catch up. You can actually hunt for an action when Tech Center is your only option. When you are breaking a base on your turn, and playing a character as a special, Ghost Spider and Spider Reflexes can give you a bit of deck foresight for Hoverbot, which can give you even more plays on your turn, potentially setting off a double or triple score, depending on how you set it up. I only endorse the robot combo because it gives Spider-Verse something to do in Phase 2, which is important to me. There are temptations to play them with another specials faction, but it's really not fun to play as or against, because there's a lot of passing. Still, if you are committed to that strategy, consider these more creative ones than the obvious pairings. What do you think of the Spider-Verse? Let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching, be sure to like and subscribe, let's shut it down.